Okay, so I'm going to show you guys how I apply my epoxy. So I have by Epoxy Lab, epoxy part A and part B, so it's a two-part. I pour mine straight into this cup. I usually do A first. I'll do 1 ounce of A and 1 ounce of B, and whatever I have left over, I just put into molds. So I'm up to my 2 ounces, so I will then use my little stirring stick here and stir these together. I know a lot of people usually just go really slow when they do this. I'm impatient, so I don't want to take 15 minutes mixing epoxy. So I get it all mixed up. I have a heat gun, so even if there are some bubbles in it, my heat gun will pop most of them. I'm gonna finish mixing this up and I'll be right back. Alright, so you mix it until it's clear. So you don't see that fog anymore. You just mix it until you don't see that. And then a lot of times I let it sit for a minute before I start. So I'll put it down and let it sit while I am getting everything ready. I just use one gloved hand. So I only touch the epoxy on the cup with one hand. I use a glove. It's just easier to feel where the rough spots and stuff are. So what I'll do is I usually try to start in just one section. Do a little bit at a time. So because I sealed my glitter before epoxying, my glitter shouldn't move, so it doesn't really matter if I start in a specific area. You just pour it all in the middle and just start rubbing it around. It doesn't really matter. So sometimes I just try to spread it out as far as I can. There's still some dry areas down here that I will get to once it comes back around. And I just continue doing this until it's fully covered. Sometimes you'll get spots that drip. That's okay, it's just getting off the excess. So you don't want it to have too much anyways. But you want it to have a decent coat. Perfect. So when you get to the rim, you want to try not to let it go over into the mug. If you do, it's fine. You can clean it up with an X-Acto knife, or sometimes I run my finger through it just to try and get the excess off before I let it cure up. So now, because we are at the edge of it, I will just take a finger and get some of the drier spots. You want to make sure you cover everything, so feel around for rough spots. Come down here to the bottom. I put it on the edge and try to kind of manipulate it to go onto the bottom to make sure that you get a good amount on the edge also, because the edge is going to be the roughest part after your first set of little bit of epoxy that you put on. Looks pretty good. All right, so I'll take my glove off. I'm done with all that. And then I will pick a glitter color. So we're gonna do this one. It's called Green Monster. It's like green and purple. So So I will dump some of this in here. You don't necessarily need too much, just enough. Mix it up. I'm going to pour it into one of these. I like to take, let me see if I can move this. I have a mess going on here. I take this and I kind of shove it down in between these just to make sure that there's stuff getting to it. And so if there's any bubbles, hopefully I'll pop them. Looks pretty good. So I'll take my like leftover glove and clean up around it when I'm done. So I'm gonna fill it just a pinch more. A lot of times when I get to this point, I'll use this to do it so that I don't make as much of a mess. It kind of just drips off of the stick. So I try really hard not to waste any of my epoxy. When I first started doing this, I wasted so much. Didn't realize how much money you waste in it. I think that's pretty full. Just a little bit more. Yeah, and then it's all set. So I let my cups. I let my cups sit overnight. I either epoxy them in the morning or at night. So, like, I epoxied this one tonight, so in the morning it'll be ready, it'll be ready to be up on the stand, like my other one over here. So, this one here, it was epoxied this morning, so I let it sit on there for 8 to 12 hours, I'd say, spinning, and so this will spin overnight, and then I will put it up on the stand in the morning, and then I can epoxy another one, and while the next one is epoxying, then I can sand this one at, I usually wait anywhere from 20 to 24 hours to sand. So then I'll sand that one and get it ready to be decaled and the last layer of epoxy. And that's it. That's the rainbow tumbler with the epoxy on it.